Alright, today I'm working on the back cover piece that goes on the transmission. Of course, you can't see. I got it covered up to keep dirt out. This is the back casing. Then there's another part that goes on the back of that. So right now I'm cleaning this surface, as you can see. Pretty bright. I'm actually cleaning this surface right here to make sure that it mates up well with the other side. As you see, all that blue gasket junk everywhere. I'm trying to keep as much out of the case as I can. I'll just wipe it out and clean it out. But I've got to get all that stuff off there and make sure the mating surface there is has no burrs on it to hold it out so it'll leak, you know. So I got to do this first, and then hopefully I'll be able to start actually assembling it today. So, till next video.
Okay, I've now got it back together, and I just wanted to go through the shifting pattern to show you how well it's doing shifting. So, this is either first or second, I don't know. As you see, it shifts first, second, third, fourth, whichever way, and then got it jams right there, but if I go back and do this, it resets it, goes up into reverse. I'm not sure, it may have to be rolling. I'm not sure why it does that, but it catches, it seems like. It goes up and down freely there, but it has to be in sync. See, it's actually shifting, so push in a second. For some reason, it doesn't want to go back. I'm not sure why that is yet. If I go like this, it turns it, it'll go up. Oh, it's a timing issue. I'm not sure what's going on with that. There you see. It's actually shifting, so that's the best I can do, I believe. So there you have it. Till next time.
Okay, here we are putting the end cover on the transmission now. Getting it all back together finally. Anyway, I wanted to make note of something here. I'm going to take this back off, and I won't be able to put it on with one hand. There's a notch right there. See that aluminum extrusion out of the housing? That notch goes right there. And if that is not lined up, this cover will not go on. And then it also lines it up with that clip there, which goes right on the end of that, which is just a piece of plastic. So it's got to line up really good. But anyway, I've got my surfaces cleaned. I'm getting ready to put a thin layer of Permatex on there, and then I'm going to put it back together and see how it does. It might even shift a little bit better. I don't know, especially since that thing's got to be held in place. So we'll see how it goes. Till next time. We have got the transmission back together. Okay, it shifts. I put the put a new throwout bearing in it. Cleaned the fork up there, the clutch fork, and brand new throwout bearing on it. Greased the shaft up some. I'm gonna wait to put the I don't know what you call them, the differential pieces, that's what attaches the axles to the transmission here. Anyway, I'm going to wait to put those in, I believe, until I get it in the car. So I stuffed those holes full of cloth to keep dirt out. Looks like I might need to recover that right there a little bit before I go putting it back in, just to keep it clean. Anyway, we are just about there. About ready to start putting it back in. There it is. Unbelievable. All right. Well, imagine the next video I'll be putting the transmission back in the car. Okay, today, after I've got this thing rebuilt, the Permatex is still wet on the transmission, but I carried it out here by myself from the garage, and I got it up underneath this car. I had to jack the engine up and jack the car up at the same time because the transmission wouldn't go underneath the car in its current position. So I had to jack it up, get it up underneath there, then let the engine back down a little bit and let the car back down on the jacks. Car stable again, but there's the transmission ready to go back in. My dilemma is, how do I do it by myself? Really hard with no lifts or anything. All I have is a jack, and I think, and this frame is going to be sitting on that frame down there because I'm not going to be bolting the transmission up yet. There's some holes there where it bolts together, you know, to the engine. I think I'm going to thread a rope through there and through the motor mounts here on the side, as you can see. I'm going to feed that rope through there. I'm going to hold the transmission up onto the frame, back away from the engine. That way, I can put the flywheel on and the clutch and pressure plate assembly. The reason I don't want to put those on right now is because there's very little space to get this transmission up in here. Barely got it past the flywheel, and when I was taking it out, if you remember, in one of the videos, it shows the clutch and pressure plate assembly had to come out to get the transmission to come out of here. Anyway, when the transmission came out of here, it just fell. So it finally came out. So it's going to be tough to get it back up in here. Hopefully it won't be as tough as it came out, but you never know. So anyway, that's our next job, is just to get it up here, because I've got a couple days here and it's supposed to rain, and I want to get this thing up here and out of the way, out of the rain. So, well, that's it for now. Until next video. All right. As you can see, I have the transmission up in this thing now, all myself. Got a jack underneath it, and then I got it tied up through the fender well. It's where it actually mounts. The top of it mounts anyway, so it's real sturdy right there. Anyway, that rope's strong enough. That transmission just isn't very heavy, really. I carried it out here. So anyway, I just got the flywheel mounted and torqued to the specifications it called for. Flywheel's all resurfaced and all shiny now. I'm getting ready to put the clutch and pressure plate in. So, it's been a big job today, I tell you. So I've assembled the whole transmission today and got it in the car. There you have it. If we get the clutch and pressure plate in a little bit, I'll do some more video. All right, well, got the new clutch in and pressure plate. As you can see, still got my tranny kind of tied. It's not actually tied up now. I've got a jack underneath it, and I'm getting ready to try to get the thing married back to the motor, which is going to be a lot of fun by myself. So anyway, just about there. Be nice if I could get it on there tonight and bolt it in at least. That would be a big relief. Starter is going to be a bear. You got to get crap underneath the car to do it. But anyway, that's where I'm at so far. So it sure has been a job. If you can see under here, I had the rope coming through here and I had it tied back down to the frame, so it actually held that transmission up. So, but I've got a jack underneath it right now, which isn't real safe. As long as I don't get underneath the thing, I'll be all right. So we'll see how it goes from here. Well, hopefully the next time I video, I will have this thing in. So, see you in a bit.
All right. It's starting to get dark. I'm going to have to quit. Anyway, I've got the transmission mounted back in here. I'm having the biggest problem, though, getting that boot back on that axle. I'm going to have to wait to get the jacks out from underneath it so I can get under there, because I have no way of getting underneath there, clear up underneath there to reach that to work on it. So I'm going to have to get the rest of the mounting done. The engine and transmission is still sitting on the jacks. I do have the transmission bolted to the engine now. So, but now I've got to get the mounts put back on so it holds itself up. And then I get them jacks out from underneath that, fix that, put the starter in, because I'm going to have to crawl underneath there to put that starter in. That ought to be fun. Anyway, still got a lot of stuff to put together. So the next day or two, hopefully I can get it all put back together. Tuesday is supposed to start raining, so I don't know if I'll get it done before then or not. But anyway, this is how far I've gotten today, and it's been a job. Thing did not want to go in. There you can see my jacks holding the engine and transmission up. I've put the other axle piece in there, a coupling, and then there's the other axle that goes in. So anyway, there it is. Well, it's been a monster. So it didn't go in very easy. It didn't just pull in there. It went in, and it was about a half inch out, and I ended up having to pull it in with bolts, and it was hard to get in there. So had one bolt in the back, I think had been stripped out before, but I ended up putting Loctite on it. I hope I never have to take it out again. It'll probably strip the aluminum clear out, and I guess I could always put a helicoil in it. But anyway, so there you have it. I'll be videoing again once I get more done.